nutrition security has been one of the top political priorities for our country, Zimbabwe, signified by high-level governance structures established during the early 1980s, particularly 1982 and 1984, when we had a meeting and there was an agreement in September 1984 that there should be a food and nutrition committee in Matabeleland, where Mudenda was the administrator. We were very excited that day, but it was still a problem. It wasn't easy. And today we see it here. The food and nutrition committees, during our time, they were called food and nutrition management committees. So we are, I'm glad maybe there is a reason why it is now just without management. We had the word management, food and nutrition committees. All the same. Let us do the same thing. Let us run with it. Unless you have a feel of it, it goes slowly. We have to get a feel of it so that we really make sure food and nutrition issues are addressed by multi-sectoral committees, ministries, or people. For us to really achieve that, one day, for it to succeed, I wish to see you addressing the members of parliament. They don't know anything about what you are talking about. They address people or every time you see them on the podium, but they are not giving them the issues to talk about. Can you draft messages or call them in the morning just for 2 hours or so and give them what you think is supposed to be part of it, of who should be their role in the food and nutrition promotion. Issues of maternal and child health and nutrition are high on the government agenda. Seeing government selected MDGs that deal with the health of the women and children. We know that until all women and children in our country are healthy and well nourished, we will not reap the benefits of a healthy and productive society, which contributes to economic growth and development. Let us also not forget the health cycle, for including the boys and the elderly who are there to support our cause of women and children being well nourished. I appreciate the efforts and results achieved by the government over the past few years in scaling up nutrition as presented previously, regardless of the difficulties the country is facing. I am aware that the commemoration of the Global Day of Action comes at a timely moment for food and nutrition security in Zimbabwe after we have launched our National Nutrition Strategy, whose vision, mission, and guiding principles have been given before I stood up. As a member of parliament in government of Zimbabwe, we are committed to accelerating actions towards the implementation of the National Nutrition Strategy, which embraces international thinking and was launched at the ZITF by the Vice President and later on disseminated in Dasa District. I would like to say that presently, government has demonstrated strong political commitment towards addressing food and nutrition security in the country, as evidenced by food security and nutrition being the first cluster in the Zim asset. This is also amplified by the exercise of a progressive food and nutrition security policy in the context of economic growth and development, which was launched by His Excellency, the President of Zimbabwe. I now stand here before you and launch the 5 key messages in the National Nutrition Strategy. A strategy for the people, a strategy for the nation, hoping for its implementation. For it to be implemented, I believe we have listed different organizations. To me, local government should be part of the priority of the people to champion the nutrition strategy. Local government's function is to plan for their areas. I heard that we want the villages, the wards, to take up the scaling up strategy. If they are to take that, they have to work with the local government. We have to find your information which we are all crying about. I told you in one of the meetings I indicated that I last saw the data, the information I left in 1989 in the local government file. Local government is different from DDC. DDC is technical people. Council is another section. It is the one which plans for the areas where they are. So if you are going to take your information, go and put it in the DDC and let it go there, when the council is planning, they don't have the data. Please make sure it passes through the three. If you pass it through the Minister of Health, let it be Minister of Health, let it come to the DDC, let it come to the council. Because the planners are the council. Those who talk to the people about it, how much diarrhea is in this area, is council, is the councillors. If you put it in the professionals, the DDC, the professionals, you are leaving out those who should clamor and say, how do you do it? It is the council who should say, how do you do it? Otherwise, it will be staying in the files in the DDC. Put it where it is also